We got another healer build, Saviors, GH here. In this video, we're gonna check out Druid, Dieb, and Cabalest. We're gonna show the classes and all the usual stuff. But as always, only the important stuff. And with this build, it's the abilities that got something to do with healing. And with that said, here is healer build version 2 of 2020. Let's do this. Okay guys, here's the build. We got Dieb, Cabalest, and Druid. And before we go to those classes, let's show the Cleric Arts first. Now, the Cleric Arts is called Cloth Mastery Healing. And what it does is give you a boost in healing in exchange for 5% of attack if you are wearing 4 pieces of cloth armor. And to explain more, let me just show you. Here I have the arts disabled and I'm healing for about 45k. And now let's enable it. And from 45k, now it heals for about 54k. So consider using cloth armor if you want more heals. Okay, I guess that settles that. Now let's do Druid. Now Druid is a shapeshifter class that uses nature to its advantage. And the reason this class is here is because of one spell, which is called Cortas Mata. And what this spell does is conjure up grass that can deal damage and also heal. Now, that's not what you need from Cortas Mata. And what you're gonna need is the Arts, which turns Cortas Mata into a full healing magic circle. It no longer deals damage, it becomes primarily for healing, which is a pretty awesome healing spell at that. And again, to better explain it, let me just show you. Now, this is Cortas Mata without the Arts. As you can see it heals about 10k without the arts. Now let's enable the art. And from 10k, it now heals 54k heal. That is some pretty good heals. The next and last spell we're gonna cover for Druid is Henge Stone. Now why Henge Stone? It's because this installation spell will increase the amount of Cortas Mata heals. Plain and simple, keep it up always. And that's Druid, one of the best class to pick in the Cleric class 3, no doubt about it. Now let's check out Dieb. Now Dieb is a wood sculptor class that can carve statues, that can buff the whole party and also attack and debuff enemies. And the reason this class is here is because of one statue, and it's called Statue of the Goddess Laima. And what it does is reduce the cooldown of spells. Now, why is that so important? It's because Cortas Mata has 20 seconds cooldown and it can last 15 seconds. Now, if you buff yourself with Statue of the Goddess Laima at max level, which reduces cooldown by 20%, you get reduced Cortas Mata cooldown. And 20% of Cortas Mata's cooldown is 4 seconds, which makes Cortas Mata's cooldown to 16 seconds only. And because of that, the downtime of Cortas Mata is only 1 second, which is pretty awesome if you ask me. Now, if you want to eliminate the cooldown of Cortas Mata totally, what you can do is get Oracle, maybe remove Cabalest here and add Oracle, and get Divine Might, which increases the level of spells by 1. And at level 11 Laima statue, you get 22% decreased cooldown, which will almost eliminate the cooldown of Cortas Mata. And if you don't want Oracle, try buying the Statue of the Goddess Laima gem that you can put on your gears. Let's go check out the market if it even exists there. Okay, it's a bit expensive, but it's there. And what else? Yeah, before erecting Laima statue, make an Osrin statue first because it will make the Laima buff remain on you even though the statue is gone. Remember, use Osrin statue first, then Laima statue. Of course, Dieb has a lot more to offer, like the Owl statue, which is your offensive statue, then the World 3 statue, which silences enemies. Amazing class for challenge mode. But that's not the focus of our video. If you have any questions about it, just ask in the comment section down below. I hope I see it because the comment section is getting too crowded for Lone Hardcore. And that's Dieppe, a must for challenge mode and endgame content that do not require much movements. And now for the last class, Kabbalist. Now, Kabbalists are priests who practice the ancient magic known as Kabbalah. They can support allies by healing and buffing them. And the reason it's here is because it can serve as a backup heal. And the Ainsoft party buff is great for boosting the healing capability of this build. Let's look at the spells. Let's start with the backup heal that I'm talking about, and it's called Tree of Sephiroth. This heals lower than Korta's Bata, and the cooldown is a bit higher. Regardless, this is here just to provide backup healing. Now, the next spell is called Ainsoft. This increases the maximum HP of your teammates for about 40 seconds if you enable the attribute, and it can also increase the amount of HP healed by Korta's Bata by 30%. If you take the attribute, which of course you're gonna have to take to get more of them heals. Now, there's more to Kabbalist than that. Just ask in the comment section if you have any. And that's the build, a pretty awesome challenge mode build. And now let's do the good and the bad. Let's start with the bad. Now, obviously, this is a healer build, and because of that, you wouldn't be as great for damaging. And I guess I should mention the lack of priest in this build. That's a con. Because I believe if you're going to protect your teammates, you don't just only protect them from damage. You also must protect them from death, which only priest can offer. And if you so happen to want to add priest in this build, just remove Kabbalist and you should be good to go. And speaking of Kabbalist, it's not that great. The contribution of Kabbalist when it comes to healing is negligible. Druid is enough for this build. And now let's do the good stuff. And oh boy, that healing garden that you have is pretty awesome. You can put it up almost always. Almost. And as I've said, this build is super awesome for challenge mode. You don't even need to do anything that much. Just skip Korta's Bata up and the statues and you're golden. All in all, I most definitely recommend this build. Although you can replace Kabbalist here for Priest or Oracle, your choice. This is an awesome healer build for endgame content nonetheless. And that's it guys, that's another healer build. I hope we get more healers in the game because CM mode players is hungry for more runs. And as always, if you like the video, hit the like button, share, and then subscribe to be part of the Gaming Hardcore family. And as always, this is Gaming Hardcore. See you in the next one.